Let's take question number 10. If z is root 3 by 2 plus iota by 2, then we have to find the expression 1 plus iz plus z5 plus iz8 whole to the power 9. We have to simplify it. So let's start this question. Given is root 3 by 2 plus iota by 2. We can change it towards omega, that is cube root of unity. How? We know that omega is actually minus 1 plus root 3 iota upon 2, or the counterpart of it, that is minus 1 minus root 3 iota upon 2. Any of the two can be taken as omega. Now, I am taking this one minus I square root 3 by 2 plus iota by 2. What I did? I multiplied this term with 1. 1 means minus I square. Now, I can take minus iota common. I will be left with minus 1 plus root 3 iota divided by 2. So let's read this term as omega. So we have minus iota omega, where omega is cube root of unity. What's the benefit for taking omega? We know that omega cube is 1, and 1 plus omega square is 0. Now, therefore, 1 plus iota z, z means minus iota omega, plus minus iota omega whole 5 plus iota into minus iota omega raised to the power 8 whole expression raised to the power 9. We have to simplify this term. Moving forward, we can write 1. I square is minus 1, so it becomes plus omega. Correct? Next, minus iota to the power 5 will give you minus iota only. Omega 5 will give you omega square. So you have minus iota omega square plus iota. Minus 1 to the power 8 is 1. Iota to the power 8 is 1. Omega to the power 8 is omega square. Whole raised to the power 9. Now we can see these two are cancelled. We are left with 1 plus omega whole to the power 9. That is minus omega square raised to the power 9. Now minus 1 to the power 9 is negative. So right here minus. Omega to the power 18 is 1. So it is simply 1. So let's see from the given options. Minus 1, that is option number 3, is the correct answer for this question. Let's move on to the next one, that is question number 11. The number of integral values of m for which the equation, this one, has no real root. Simple. No real root meaning discriminant should be less than 0. So let's go for it. Looks a bit calculative, but not difficult. 1 plus 3m whole square minus 4 times 1 plus m square multiplied with 1 plus 8m. This should be less than 0. Simplifying, 4 can be thrown to the other side. We are left with 1 plus 6m plus 9m square minus 1 plus 8m plus m square plus 8m cube less than 0. Simplifying further, highest power is 8m cube with negative sign. Throw negative on the other side. Write it as 8m cube. Next. Minus m square plus 9m square, that is plus 8m square, but minus already taken common, so minus 8m square. Next, 6m minus 8m, so it becomes plus 2m, then 1 cancelled, greater than 0. So we can take 2m common. We are left with 4m square minus 4m plus 1, that is 2m minus 1 whole square greater than 0. So the simple conclusion is m is greater than 0, but m is not equal to half. Now, question is talking about integral values of m. How many integral values of m are there? Infinitely many, because m is greater than 0. So 1, 2, 3 and so on. So simply the result is infinitely many solutions. Correct answer is option number 1. Let's move on to the next question. Let the numbers 2, B, C be in AP. A, a matrix given. If determinant A is lying in the interval 2 to 16, both inclusive, then C lies in the interval. So let's start this question. Determinant A is equal to determinant of 1, 1, 1, 2. Let's see common difference is D, then we can say B is 2 plus D because it is given 2BC are in AP. So I can write B as 2 plus D and C as 2 plus 2D. So writing here 2 plus D, 2 plus 2D, moving ahead 4, 2 plus D whole square, 2 plus 2D whole square. I'm sure this is clear. Now, applying C2 replaced with C2 minus C1 and C3 replaced with C3 minus C1. What we get? We are getting determinant A is equal to 1, 2, 4, the first column. Next, second column is simply 0, D, 4 will be cancelled, we will be left with D square plus 4D, then 0, 2D, 4D square plus 8D. That's clear? Now, we can take D common from second and third columns. We have D square multiplied with expanded then. We get simply 1 multiplied with 4D plus 8. So we have 4D plus 8 minus 2 multiplied with D plus 4. So 2D minus 8. 8 is cancelled. We are getting result as 2D cube. Right. Now what is given to me? It is given to me determinant A is lying in the interval 2 to 16. So going with the approach that this term 2D cube is lying in the interval 2 to 16. 2 cancelled, we get D is lying in the interval 1, 2, 2. Question is, in which interval C is lying? What is C? C is 2 plus 2D. So just get the result. Therefore, 2 plus 2D is lying in the interval 2 plus 2 and 2 plus 4. Therefore, C is lying in the interval 4 to 6. So I'm sure this question is clear. C is lying in the interval 4 to 6. Is it available? Yes, option number 4 is the correct answer. I'm sure this is clear. Let's move on to the next one.